Now their wind-up is on. Rafael Majka has had the call. It's time to go. Narvaez is the first victim out the back. And look at the reaction. Look at the face of Arensman. Poggy goes. Can anybody go with him? Rafael Majka looks across his shoulder. Danny Martinez is the first to try and sweep around the outside. This is a gap in a hurry. The Pog is on fire. A minute and 20 seconds now. It is a counter going down as if you put something in the microwave and you're waiting for it to be ready to eat. He's just about done with cooking Naro Quintana. On the climbing starts again for Naro Quintana. With 4 kilometres remaining, it's a 39-second advantage. It would be a miracle if he survives.
Well, this is a real testing point for Naro Quintana, because often when you're doing a long climb, if you have a short descent within that climb, it breaks your rhythm, you cool down a little bit, and it can be very challenging to re-accelerate.
The shoulders moving more than on the previous climb. Are we starting to see the fatigue build for Tadej Pogacar? Could Quintana possibly respond? The Pog is winding up. He looks as if he is not going to give Quintana a chance to get into his slipstream. 2 kilometres to go. Does he collect and press on forward? So much Colombian support. Pogacar straight on by. Naro Quintana, his head, it doesn't even turn to the right. He bows in appreciation to Tornado Taddy. Into the last 100 metres, and it keeps going skyward.
Oh, 150 metres to go now. What a grueling run up to the finish. This final climb up will have felt like it's taken a lifetime.
It's so steep you can read the logos on his wheels. There's the last crest. He's just about over it. Clawing his way to the top. Now he can relax as he sees the finish line. Tadej Pogacar has ridden the final mountain in isolation in a day of climbing meditation as he takes the win in Livigno. Extraordinary.